If f of x is equal to minus x, defined on the closed interval 0, 1 and the partition P is equals to the set containing the points 0, 1/3, 2/3, 1, that is this partition contains 4 partition points and hence we will be getting 3 sub intervals. This P is a partition of the closed interval 0 to 1. Then we have to find upper dot box sum and lower dot box sum. This is the graph of y is equals to minus x. Here y equal to f of x. That means whenever x is 1, y value will be minus 1. X is minus 1, y value will be plus 1. X is minus 5, y value will be 5. X is 10, y value will be minus 10. Let us trace the graph. This is a tracing. See that this graph is passing through the origin. And you see the point here, when x is 0.015, y value will be minus 0.015. The only difference is the minus sign. This is a decreasing curve because as the value of x increases, value of y decreases. X value is increasing, y value is decreasing. So this is the graph of y equal to minus x. Y equal to minus x is a decreasing curve or a straight line which is passing through the origin. Solution. Here the function f of x is equals to minus x, which is a decreasing function on the given interval 0 to 1. We are going to find the infimum of the function f of x with respect to each and every subinterval. Small m1 is the infimum of the function f of x in the first subinterval, namely I1. Normally to find the infimum, we take the first, the starting value of any subinterval. But here, the function is a decreasing function. Therefore, we have to take the last endpoint, not the first point, the next point, the last endpoint, namely 1/3. So, we have to keep x is equal to 1/3 in the given function because it is a decreasing function. Note that this is something different from all other problems so far we have discussed. Therefore, keep x is equal to 1/3 in f of x, we get minus of 1/3 is minus 1/3 is small m1. What is small m2? Infimum of the function f of x in the second subinterval. That is, in the place of x, we have to keep 2/3. Therefore, it is f of 2/3 is minus 2/3. Minus 2/3 is small m2. Small m3 is the infimum of f of x in the third subinterval, namely the closed interval 2/3, 1. Since we are going to find the infimum for the decreasing function, let us keep x is equals to 1 here. Therefore, it is minus 1. Thus, the infimum of the function f in I1, I2, I3 are minus 1/3, -2/3 and minus 1 respectively. We are going to find the supremum of the function f with respect to I1, I2, I3. Capital M1 is the supremum of the function f of x in the first subinterval. Since we are going to find the supremum for a decreasing function, we have to take the first value as x. Therefore, keep x is equal to 0 here. It is minus 0 is 0. M2, capital M2 is the supremum of f of x in the second subinterval. Therefore, replace x by 1 by 3. So, it is minus 1 by 3. Capital M3 is the supremum of f of x in the third subinterval, namely closed interval 2 by 3 comma 1 to get M3. Replace x by 2 by 3, that is minus 2 by 3. And we know that infimum is always less than or equals to the supremum. Look at this here, M1 value is minus 1 by 3, capital 1 is 0. Which is greater? 0 is greater than minus 1 by 3. Similarly here, small M2 is minus 2 by 3, capital M2 is minus 1 by 3. Which is greater? Minus 1 by 3 is greater than minus 2 by 3. Similarly, minus 2 by 3 is greater than minus 1. Therefore, remember that for a decreasing function, we have to deal differently. And delta r is 1 by 3 because the difference is always 1 by 3 for r equals to 1, 2, 3. Now we know the infimum and supremum of the function f of x with respect to I1, I2, I3. We also know the length of the subintervals. Now let us find upper Riemann sum. Upper Riemann sum is u of p comma f. It is m1, capital m1 delta 1 plus capital m2 delta 2 plus capital m3 delta 3. Since we know the values of capital m1, m2, m3, substitute here. M1 is 0, capital m2 is minus 1 by 3, capital m3 is minus 2 by 3, delta 1 is 1 by 3, delta 2 is 1 by 3, delta 3 is 1 by 3. Now 1 by 3 is a common factor, take it out. Therefore 0 plus minus 1 by 3 minus 2 by 3, that is equals to minus 3 by 3 is minus 1, and hence minus 1 into 1 by 3 is minus 1 by 3. Therefore upper Riemann sum is minus 1 by 3. Now what is lower Riemann sum? The lower Dauerbach sum or the lower Riemann sum is equals to small m1 delta 1 plus small m2 delta 2 plus small m3 delta 3. Substitute the values of m1, m2, m3 and delta 1, delta 2, delta 3. We get minus 1 by 3 into 1 by 3 plus m2. Small m2 is minus 2 by 3, delta 2 is 1 by 3, small m3 is minus 1 into 1 by 3. 1 by 3 is a common factor, therefore we get minus 1 by 3, minus 2 by 3, minus 1. If we take LCM, we get minus 2. Therefore it is minus 2 into 1 by 3 is minus 2 by 3. Remember that u of p comma minus f is minus of l of p comma f. Also l of p comma minus f is equals to minus of u of p comma f. In this problem y equal to x, l of p of f is 1 by 3, u of p comma f is 2 by 3. Whereas in the problem we are discussing now, L of P of minus F is minus 2 by 3. U of P of minus F is minus 1 by 3. This note says that U of P comma minus F is minus of L of P comma F. We know that L of P comma F in that problem, namely Y equals to F of X equal to X, it is 1 by 3. Therefore, here u of p comma f is minus 1 by 3, same value, because here f is nothing but minus x. There f of x is x, here f of x is minus x. Similarly here l of u p comma f, in y equal to x, u of p comma f value is 2 by 3. And the result says that l of p comma minus f will be minus of u of p comma f. Here f of x is y, that is equal to x. Here f of x is minus x. therefore it is minus 2 by 3. Hence, L of P comma minus F is minus 2 by 3.